All right, everybody. Welcome in for game two. My name is David Davenport. I'm here with you calling the game as we got the Bearcats of St. Vincent's again going against the Builders, the Apprentice School. Let me try to pull up something here. Let's look at the lineups real quick. So the Builders in the field line up pretty much the same as game one. Matt Phoebus in left. Nate Yeary in center. Jet Winslow in right. Ellis is at third. Cam Weston at short. Nolan Edwards at second. Hunter Johnson at first. Aiden Henry's doing the pitching today. And Jeremy Harmon is doing the catching. He was the DH the first game. And doing the DHing for this game will be Caleb Russell. So Aiden Henry has a 4.2 ERA. He's got a 1-0 win-loss record. He's appeared in four games. This is his fifth game, making his fourth start. And his first pitch at 3:59 is, I'm assuming, a ball because I didn't see anything called. So quickly, 2-0. St. Vincent, it's pretty much the exact same batting order as the first game. The only change there is that Derek Hald is batting eighth and catching. Other than that, it's the same. So this is Dylan Schmoody, their leadoff batter and center fielder, as he pokes that to short. And he'll get on with an infield hit. That'll bring up the second baseman, Mario Disso. And that first pitch is in for a ball. Second pitch is in for a strike. So game four of the four-game set in 2 days against the Builders and the Bearcats. A little low on that one. 2-1. Bearcats making a lot of noise in their dugout. Throw over to first. He gets back safely. The 2-1 pitch is hit into right field. I just saw Connor running down the foul line. That's why I said Connor. Jet makes a catch. And Dylan retreats back to first. So that'll bring up the third baseman, Vincent Antitucci. Antitucci had a productive first game. He had a sack, bunt, singled twice, scored once. First pitch he sees is a strike. Builders trying to right the ship after that loss in that first game of today. Their fourth loss of the season as a whole. Second pitch is in for a strike. Of course, it's that time of day where the shadows get to play. Play mind games with the batters. He swings and misses for strike three. Second out of the inning. So I'll bring up Billy Perez. I wrote Perez on my sheet. First pitch was a ball. Runner goes and gets safe and safely. Two oh count, runner at second, two outs. That pitch is fouled away. Strike one. And that's hit hard towards left field, rolls through, one runner's around and scores on that single to left. So that'll bring up the first baseman, Austin Turpak. Turpak walked, singled, got on every at bat. He walked once, scored two runs. The first pitch he saw in this set game two was a ball. He makes some contact there. Jet Winslow makes a catch out and right, and that'll do it. St. Vincent scores one run on two hits. No errors. One man left on base. We'll be back for the bottom of the first inning and the Builders' first chance at the plate after this.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII. Building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy. The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans. Thanks to them, we all have our freedom and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina and I work for HII.
All right, welcome back. Let's take a look at how the Bearcats are going to line up in the field for this game, too. They've got Evans in left, Schmoody in center, Perez in right, Amatucci at third, Hess at short, Disso at second, and Turpik at first. The only change, like I mentioned before, is Hall at catching, and McAller is doing the pitching. And this is his third appearance and second start overall. He's had five and a third innings of work. And the Builders lead off with Nate Erie. And the rest of their batting order looks like this. Maybe it'll look like something. Well, it's not showing up. So we'll get to that in a minute. So Nate Erie's up first, followed by Jeremy Harmon, then Nolan Edwards, and then Caleb Russell's DHing, batting cleanup. The first pitch was a strike. Second pitch was a ball. Batting fifth is Cam Weston, then Hunter Johnson and Riggs Ellis. Matt Phoebus is batting eighth, and Jet Winslow is batting ninth. So 1-2 is the count now to Nate. So this is also the time of day where the sun and the shadows play games with my cameras. As Nate grounds out to the shortstop for the first out of the inning. So that'll bring Jeremy Harmon to the plate. Jeremy went two for four with a walk, a single, and a double in the first game. Swing and a miss for strike one. Count is even at 1-1. That pitch is in for strike two. Outside, ball two. Counts even at 2-2. And that ball's popped high, but out of play. Jeremy Harmon fouls that one. Back towards the Builder dugout in between Nolan and Coach Jones. And he gets him swinging. Strike three for the second out of the inning. Brings up Nolan Edwards. Nolan's quickly ahead in the count, 2-0. As he fouls that one towards the visitor's dugout on the first baseline. Nat's in there for strike two. And he gets him swinging for strike three. So that'll do it. The Builders go 1-2-3 in their half of the inning. Bearcats get ready to come up for the top half of the second. We'll be back with more Builder Baseball here on the Builder Sports YouTube channel.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII, building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy. The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans. Thanks to them, we all have our freedom, and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII.
Welcome back in for the top of the second inning. The Builders went 1-2-3 in their half of the inning, which is not helpful. And I missed how St. Vincent ended their half of the inning. So go back, make ruin. Go back and take a look. So Terpik flied out to right. That's right. So that brings up 6, 7, 8 hitters. The DH Jacob Ald will lead off, followed by LJ Evans, and then Derek Hald. While those two names sound very similar, they are different. One is A-U-L-D, and the other one is H-A-L-D. First pitch he sees was a ball. Swing and a miss, strike. So Ald went he also reached base every at-bat. He walked and was hit by a pitch. Scored a run, so he also had a very effective game one from the plate. Counts even now at 2-2. So Aiden is semi-efficiently working through this one so far. Through the first inning, he had one strikeout. There's a second strikeout. For the first out of this inning, you got that one looking. I'll bring LJ Evans to the plate. So he's thrown 20 pitches now. He squares the bunt, pulls back, ball one. He swings away, fouls that one towards his own dugout. Some of them turn out of the way. Fouls it back again to his own dugout. Some of them have to jump out of the way. That ball is hit high into center field. Nate Erie's there for the grab. Oh, wrong button. for the second out of the inning. That'll bring up Derek Hald, the catcher, which he came in towards the end of the game, of game one, and caught. He was 0-for-1 with a sack bunt and flied out in the first game. Well, 1-2 is the count. And he fouls that one down the third base line. Just keep the count at 1-2. That pitch skipped up there, 2-2. A little high, 3-2. Count full, and that pitch is ripped foul. Three-two pitch. He walks him. For any SEC basketball fans out there, Auburn won their game, their semifinal game, beating Mississippi State 73-66. The second semifinal is underway right now with 10 minutes left in the first half. A&M is beating Florida 26-16. That ball's popped high in the air. Cam's under it, squeezes it for the third out of the inning. Bearcats got no runs. On a walk. One man left on base. We'll be back for the bottom of the second inning in just a moment here on the Builders Sports YouTube channel.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII,
building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy. The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans. Thanks to them, we all have our freedom and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina and I work for HII.
All right, welcome back for the bottom of the second inning. Builders have 4, 5, 6 due up. Seeing as they went 1, 2, 3 in the top of the inning. So Caleb Russell is going to lead it off, followed by Cam Weston and then Hunter Johnson. So Builders look to cut into the lead and maybe even take the lead. Caleb looks at strike one. Second pitch is in there for ball. Ball two. Three and one's a count. Caleb loops that one to right field, and the right fielder doesn't make the catch. And Russell turns and makes it to second with a stand-up double. So that'll bring up Cam Weston. He went 2 for 4 in the first game. With two singles. As Sean McAller checked the runner and then stepped off. Pitch. High, ball one. That one's in there for a strike, 1-1. As that pitch is fouled away, it bounced on the other side of the fence, I believe, in the little walkway right there by the Builders Clubhouse. One and two's the count. That pitch is fouled off over the first baseline. Cam drops that one into left field as the left fielder dives. It gets by him. So Cam is in at second. And Caleb comes around to score. And that brings up Hunter Johnson, the first baseman. Hunter was 2-for-4 in the first game. First pitch he sees in this game, 2, is a strike. So we got Cam at second, Hunter at the plate. No outs here in the top of the bottom of the second inning. Strike 2. 1-2 is the count. And Hunter strikes that ball into left field. Evans is under it, makes the catch. And Cam retreats back to first. Back to second base. Brings up the third baseman, Riggs Ellis. First pitch he sees is a strike. That pitch was outside for ball 1. Riggs fouls that one away for strike 2. That one's inside. Ball. Counts even at 2-2. Three and two. Riggs fouls that one off. The catcher goes out to talk to the pitcher. And that ball's blooped into center over the second baseman's head. Around comes Cam. He's going to score standing. That'll bring up Matt Phoebus. Matt Phoebus grounds it to the short. He flips it. 1-6-4-3 double play gets them out of the inning. The Builders score two runs on three hits, no errors, one man left on base. We'll be back for the top of the third inning right after this.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII,
building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy. The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans. Thanks to them, we all have our freedom and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina and I work for HII.
Welcome back. Top of the third inning. Builders lead 2-1 as St. Vincent put up one run in the top of the first and the Builders put up two in the bottom of the second. Top of the lineup due up for St. Vincent's. We got Dylan Schmoody to lead it off, followed by Mario Disso and then Vincent Amatucci. First pitch there is in for a strike. Strike two. It's a little low, ball one. That ball's popped high into the air and caught by Hunter Johnson. I'll bring up the second baseman, Mario Disso. He's 0-for-1 in this second game. He flew out to right field. Yeah, right field in his first at-bat. Pitches in there for a strike. Second pitch was a ball. 1-1's a count. And that pitch is pulled foul down the first baseline. One, two, hit into center field. Nate Erie's on the charge coming in. He makes the grab for out number two. That brings up the third baseman, Vincent Amatucci. I'm sorry. He struck out in his first at-bat of this game two. First pitch he sees is outside for ball one. Foul tip back for to the wall for strike one. One on one's a count. Aiden turns and fires. A little low. Kind of bounced in there. A 2-1 pitch. Fouled off. Coach Scarola comes down to pick up the baseball. Two-two pitch. Swing and a miss. Strike three. That'll do it for this half inning. As the Bearcats go down, one, two, three, we'll be back for the Builders half of this of the third inning in just a moment here on the Builder Sports YouTube channel.
The USC Durham provides our program exactly what they say, a chance for small colleges to compete. It's leveling the playing field for everybody.
Here to War Memorial Stadium for the bottom of the third inning, where the Builders have a lead of 2-1. Leading off the third inning will be Jet Winslow, so the Builders are going to have 9-1-2 coming up. So it'll be Jet Winslow followed by Nate Erie and Jeremy Harmon. So Jet sees his first pitch come in, and it's a ball. We had a little Red Hot Chili Peppers playing in between innings. This is Jet. Hits that one foul down the first base and right field line. That ball's fouled into the ground for strike two. So the 2-2 pitch was outside. Moves the count to 3-2. Chet Winslow's got himself a full count. As he grounds that ball to the third baseman, and Matucci scoops it up, makes the throw over to first. It was off the bag, but the tag was applied for the first out of the inning. So that'll bring Nate Yeary to the plate. He grounded out to the shortstop in his first at-bat of this game, too. He taps that one foul right in front of the fan sitting down the left field brick wall over by the concession stand. You come out here to War Memorial, you get yourself a hot dog, some chips and candy. Strike two. Outside, ball one. Inside, ball two. Counts now even at 2-2. Some big old swing and a miss for strike three and the second out of this inning. Brings Jeremy Harmon to the plate where he struck out in his first at-bat. Jeremy pops it just past the reach of the shortstop. So that brings up Nolan Edwards, the second baseman, who also struck out in his first at-bat. So Nolan steps in. First pitch is way outside, and Harmon had one heck of a secondary lead there. Swing and a miss. First strike one. Nolan calls time. Looked like he had some. That pitch was way outside as Harmon takes the base easy. Jeremy Harmon is now 3-for-4 in the stolen base department. Strike two. Counts even at 2-2. A 2-2 pitch. A weak swing and a miss by Nolan. That'll do it for the Builders. They scored no runs. One hit, one man left. We'll be back for the top, the fourth inning. Just a moment here on the Builders Sports YouTube channel.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII,
building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy. The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans. Thanks to them, we all have our freedom, and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII.
Welcome back. Top of the fourth inning here at War Memorial Stadium, where it's 4-5-6 due up for the St. Vincent College Bearcats. Billy Perez is going to lead it off, followed by Austin Turpak and Jacob Ald. So Billy Perez is up. First pitch he sees is a strike. Again, pitches the ball. Swings and drives that one to left, and it's caught by Matt Phoebus. So I'll bring up the first baseman, Austin Turpak. He's 0-1 today. Flew out to the right fielder back in the first inning. First pitch he saw was a ball. And that one's in there for a strike. Ball two, counts 2-1. One pitch, 3-1. And that skips in for ball four. That'll bring up Jacob Auld, the DH. Swing and a miss, strike one. Jacob struck out looking in his first at-bat of the game. Throw over, gets back safely. Swing and a miss, strike two. Throw over again. He gets back safely. Outside. 1-2. Swing and misses, strike three. Second out of the inning. That'll bring up LJ Evans, the left fielder. He flew out to center his first at bat. As he bats here with two outs in the top of the fourth inning. Runner on first. And he pulls that one foul down the first baseline. Swing and a miss, strike two. 0-2 is the count, two outs. The 0-2 pitch. It's hit to Nolan. Scoops it up, throws to first, and that'll do it. Third out of the inning. Builders looking to add to their lead in the bottom of the fourth. We'll be back here on Builders YouTube.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII,
building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy.
The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans. Thanks to them, we all have our freedom and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina and I work for HII.
Right, welcome back for the bottom of the fourth inning. Due up for the Builders is 4-5-6, Caleb Russell, Cam Weston, Hunter Johnson for the Builders here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Builders looking to add to the lead. Caleb's 1-for-1 today. He doubled. When he led off the second inning. doubled to right field. And then scored. First pitch was in there for a ball. Swing and a miss for strike one. 2-1's a count. Caleb hits that in the gap in left center for a single. Brings up the shortstop, Cam Weston. He also doubled to left his first at-bat, driving in Caleb and then later scoring in that second inning. First pitch he sees is the ball. Second pitches in for a strike. Ball's hit into right field. It's going to get down. Russell's going to turn second and head for third. And Cam is going to take second on the throw. That'll bring up Hunter Johnson, who flied out to right in his first at-bat. Runners on second and third, nobody out here in the bottom of the fourth inning. Hunter Johnson swings through that first pitch. Strike one. Strike two. The 0-2 pitch. Fouled straight back. So we'll do it over. Hunter grounds that to first. It bounces off the first baseman's glove. And no one moves up. It'll bring Riggs Ellis to the plate. And that first pitch was in there for a strike. They say he went. Strike two. Counts one and two. That ball's fouled off. Riggs fouls another one off. Riggs singled in his first at bat of this game. And he swings through that one, strike three for the second out of the inning. It'll bring up Matt Phoebus, the left fielder. He hit into a double play in his first at-bat. And he hits that ball hard up the middle. Great stop by the second baseman. But the ball got by the first baseman as Caleb scores. And Cam scores, and they give Matt Phoebus second base on the air. I'll bring up Jet Winslow. He grounded out to the third baseman in his first at bat. First pitch he saw was a ball. Popped that up and out of play. 1-1's a count. Ball two. Pitch, strike two. Counts even at 2-2. count is full. 3-2. Two outs. So Matt Phoebus will get a little bit of a head start from second base. He'll be taking off on the pitch. And he got him looking. That'll do it for the Builders. The Builders do score two runs on three hits, one error, and they leave one man on base. We'll be back for the top of the fifth inning after this here on Builders Sports YouTube channel.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII, building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy. The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans. Thanks to them, we all have our freedom and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina and I work for HII.
Welcome back here to War Memorial Stadium for the top of the fifth inning. Due up for the Bearcats is Hald, Hess, and then Schmoody. So they're going to have the 8-9-1 hitters due up this half inning. As Aiden Henry comes out for his fifth inning of work. Through four innings, Aiden has one earned run allowed. He's struck out four batters, walked two, and thrown 61 pitches. So Derek Hald is up. He's 0-for-1 today. Actually, he's 0-for-0 because he walked in his first at-bat. First pitch he sees is a ball. So that's 2-0 to Derek as Aiden delivers. Okay, apparently we all missed a pitch because everywhere I look, I only saw that that was the third ball. But it was apparently the fourth. So that'll bring up Alex Hess, the shortstop. He flew out to the shortstop in his first at-bat. The first pitch he sees is a strike. He hits that one just by Riggs Ellis, and it gets into left field. So that takes us to the top of the order in Dylan Schmoody, where he's 1-for-2 today, singled and flown out to the first baseman. As Caleb, not Caleb, as Jeremy Harmon goes out to talk to the pitcher. Schmoody squared to bunt, and he bunts the first pitch foul. He's trying to play small ball in a way, move the runners over, get him in scoring position. The 0-1 pitch. In there for strike two. I would assume Dylan would be swinging away now. Because now a bunt, if it's placed foul, would be an out. One and two is the count. That ball's hit sharply to short, and it goes off Cam's foot into left field. And that'll get Derek hauled around to score. And that'll be the end of the day for Aiden. We'll introduce you to the new pitcher when we come back. So we'll be right back, and I'll introduce the new pitcher then.
The thing that sets Worley's apart is that our people here truly care. They're here because they love their jobs and they want to learn more.
What I like about Worley's is the people, the team I work with every day.
My favorite thing about working at Worley's is that it's more like a family. I mean, it is work, but it's not.
They actually treat me like a person and not a number. And this is the first company where I really feel like I belong.
Here at Worley's, it's a great atmosphere. They really care about the customers, really care about the employees. We do whatever we got to do to make the job right.
Like the team. Everybody's a team.
All right. Never mind. Up now is Mario Disso, the second baseman. There is no new pitcher. I saw the pitcher running out, so I assumed we had a pitching change. We do not. And he gets the bunt down. The pitcher turns, fires, and that throw goes up the line, way into up the line. Good night. So that's a two-run bunt, and now we will have a pitching change. And we'll be back after this to introduce the new pitcher.
The thing that sets Worley's apart is that our people here truly care. They're here because they love their jobs and they want to learn more.
What I like about Worley's is the people, the team I work with every day.
My favorite thing about working at Worley's is that it's more like a family. I mean, it is work, but it's not.
They actually treat me like a person and not a number. And this is the first company where I really feel like I belong.
Here at Worley's, it's a great atmosphere. They really care about the customers, really care about the employees. We do whatever we got to do to make the job right.
Like the team, everybody's a team player. All about doing the right thing for the customer, taking pride in your work. It's just overall a great company to work for.
You know, we really do have an awesome set of guys. It's kind of cool. We got a great team. We have fun together, from my plumbers to my air conditioning guys to my crawl space guys. Everybody like works together as a team. They're just phenomenal.
We have training programs. We like it when people come in. They don't really know what they want to do, and we're able to help them find a trade and do things such as like a paid for apprenticeship programs for HVAC, plumbing, electrical. We've sent people as far as Texas to also doing them here locally. We just truly like to see our people grow and succeed and get to the next step of their career. We want people here who truly aspire to be the best in their fields.
All right, welcome back. The new pitcher is number 12, Dawson Adams. He's 1-0 this season in 5 appearances, so this is his 6th appearance with 2 starts under his belt. He's thrown 13 and a third innings total. First pitch he throws is a strike. That ball's fouled down the line for strike 2. And the batter is Vincent Amatucci, the third baseman. That pitch was low for ball 1. And Adams picks that ball up, throws it to first for the out. Wait, he called him safe? Okay, never mind. He called him safe. I could have swore he was out. Pitch was well outside for a ball. Second pitch is in there for a strike. Foul tip, strike 2. That one fouled off the back of the screen towards the top of it. Swing and a miss. For strike three in the first out of the inning. That brings up Austin Turpak. As he fouls that ball away. First strike one. Inside. 1-1. Amatucci takes off, and that pitch is fouled away again. That ball's hit into right. Jet gets under it, makes a catch, but the runner will come in. Bringing up Jacob Auld. Oh, he's being pinch hit for. By Dalton Niclo. He's worked a 1-1 count. Runner Amatucci takes off again, and he's out. And St. Vincent scores four runs on two hits with two errors and nobody left on base. We'll be back for the Builders half of the fourth inning. I'm sorry, not the fourth inning, the fifth inning. After this.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII,
building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy. The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans,
Thanks to them, we all have our freedom and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina and I work for HII.
Who was caught stealing? All right, so we got Nate Urie leading off this bottom of the fifth inning for the Builders. The first pitch he sees is a ball. Second pitch is a ball. That hits the outside corner for strike one. The Builders have the top of the lineup here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Pitch must have been low because it looked like about the same location over the plate as the last pitch. It's a 2-1 pitch. I'm sorry, the 3-1 pitch. It's hit to right, left field, and Evans makes the catch. So that brings up Jeremy Harmon, the catcher. He's 1-for-2 today with a strikeout and a single to left. Pitch was well outside. That one's in there for a strike. Just outside. Ball two. 2-1's a count on Jeremy. Swing and a miss. Strike two. That one sliced out of play down the right field line. That one's fouled just to my right. Two pitch. Outside 3-2. And Jeremy hits that one into center field. It's going to take a couple bounces before it's picked up by Schmoody and thrown in. Brings up Nolan Edwards, the second baseman, who is 0-for-2 today with two strikeouts. And we're going to get mound visit by the pitching coach. So, actually, they have kind of like the, I can't think of what it's called in the majors, but the, in essence, the catcher gets the pitch from the pitching coach. Verbally, he takes, Harmon takes off, and he's in there safe. A 1-0 pitch. That one skips up there for 2-1. Outside, ball three. 3-1 is a count. So Nolan's looking at a 3-1 pitch. Very much a hitter-friendly count. He can shrink the zone a little bit. Look for his pitch. Jeremy Harmon on second. And that pitch is way inside. And Nolan draws a walk, which will bring up Caleb Russell to the plate. Oh, my gosh. And that'll do it for this pitcher. I'll introduce you to the new Bearcat pitcher in just a moment. Stay tuned.
The thing that sets Worley's apart is that our people here truly care. They're here because they love their jobs and they want to learn more.
What I like about Worley's is the people, the team I work with every day.
My favorite thing about working at Worley's is that it's more like a family. I mean, it is work, but it's not.
They actually treat me like a person and not a number. And this is the first company where I really feel like I belong.
Here at Worley's, it's a great atmosphere. They really care about the customers, really care about the employees. We do whatever we got to do to make the job right.
Like the team, everybody's a team player. All about doing the right thing for the customer, taking pride in your work. It's just overall a great company to work for.
You know, we really do have an awesome set of guys. It's kind of cool. We got a great team. We have fun together, from my plumbers to my air conditioning guys to my crawl space guys. Everybody like works together as a team. They're just phenomenal.
We have training programs. We like it when people come in. They don't really know what they want to do, and we're able to help them find a trade and do things such as like a paid for apprenticeship programs for HVAC, plumbing, electrical. We've sent people as far as Texas to also doing them here locally. We just truly like to see our people grow and succeed and get to the next step of their career. We want people here who truly aspire to be the best in their fields.
All right, welcome back in. New pitchers number 11, Joshua Daly. Honestly, I don't remember if he pitched yesterday or not, so I'm just going to say it's his third appearance of the season. As he faces Caleb Russell, who has doubled and singled in today's second game. And Caleb has quickly earned a 2-0 count. As they throw back to second. They throw back again, except this time the second baseman was actually in a position to make a play. Low ball 3-0. Strike. Three-one pitch coming. Runners on first and second. One out. Builders looking to put up a run or two, and that's a walk to load them up. Brings up Cam Weston, the shortstop. He's doubled and singled. Man, oddly enough, Caleb and Cam's we're going to stay here, and I'm going to talk and make stuff up as I go. We have a pitching change because the guy who was just pitching walked a batter who did the exact same thing the last guy did before he got pulled. He walked a batter. But that's neither here nor there. But before this at-bat for Russell, Caleb and Cam's at-bats are kind of very similar. In the second inning, Caleb's doubled to right, followed by Cam, who doubled to left. They both later, Caleb scored when Cam doubled, and then Cam later scored. And their second at-bats, which Caleb, in both of his at-bats, led off an even-numbered inning, the second and fourth. Caleb singled to left field and later scored, followed by Cam, who singled to right field and then later scored. So, they have followed suit on each other, just hitting the ball to the opposite field of each other. So, I guess it's a wait and see. Does Cam turn around and follow suit and walk? Get himself walked again? Who knows? The new pitcher is number 39. Troy Gilpin, and I almost positive he did not pitch in either game yesterday. So this is his second appearance on the season. He's pitched two-thirds of an inning. So he has very little stats on him, but his two-thirds of an inning were apparently very effective because he has not given up a hit or a run. So he has a staggering zero ERA, but again, that's on a small sample size of two batters because he did not allow a walk either. So here's Cam up to bat, bases loaded, no one out. Bottom of the fifth inning here. First pitch is a strike. Second pitch is a strike. So Cam's looking at an 0-2 count. And he fouls that one away. Troy has a kind of an interesting delivery. It's very vertical. When he drives off the rubber, he doesn't seem to get lower like most pitchers do. Grounded to third. Throw home. One there. So that'll bring up Hunter Johnson, the first baseman, batting with the bases loaded and two outs. The first pitch he sees is a ball. And there's Nolan with a head first slide in on that pass ball. Give the builders tie it up. Hunter's looking at a 2-0 count. And there's a balk. So that'll balk a runner in. So Russell will score. And Hunter draws a walk. Oh. He gave up a walk. He gets the hook. We'll be back, and I'll introduce you to the new picture after this word for Whirlies.
The thing that sets Whirlies apart is that our people here truly care. They're here because they love their jobs and they want to learn more.
What I like about Whirlies is the people. The team I work with every day.
My favorite thing about working at Whirlies is that it's more like a family. I mean, it is work, but it's not.
They actually treat me like a person and not a number. And this is the first company where I really feel like I belong.
Here at Whirlies, it's a great atmosphere. They really care about the customers, really care about the employees. We do whatever we got to do to make the job right.
Like the team, everybody's a team player. All about doing the right thing for the customer, taking pride in your work. It's just overall a great company to work for.
You know, we really do have an awesome set of guys. It's kind of cool. We got a great team. We have fun together, from my plumbers to my air conditioning guys to my crawl space guys. Everybody like works together as a team. They're just phenomenal.
We have training programs. We like it when people come in, they don't really know what they want to do, and we're able to help them find a trade and do things such as like a paid for apprenticeship programs for HVAC, plumbing, electrical. We've sent people as far as Texas to also doing them here locally. We just truly like to see our people grow and succeed and get to the next step of their career. We want people here who truly aspire to be the best in their fields.
Right. So the new pitcher is 27, Andrew Root. He actually pitched in the last game. There's a foul ball. 0-2 is the count. What I'm hearing from the other side of the wall, it's 29 out there in the bullpen throwing, which I think he pitched in the last game as well. Oh, they got him. And Hunter got picked off at first, so that'll do it for the Builders here in the bottom of the fifth inning. They do get two runs on one hit, no errors, and one man left on base. We'll be back for the top of the sixth inning in just a moment.
USCAA provides our program exactly what they say, a chance for small colleges to compete. It's leveling the playing field for everybody.
Alright, welcome back. If you remember way back when, in the top of the fifth inning, It ended with a caught stealing. So that'll bring Dalton Niccolo back to the plate. I think baseball should change the rules. If the guy gets caught stealing, I almost feel like you should go back to the plate with the count you had. I mean, it's almost like you get to redo the whole at-bat over again. I don't know what the count was because I didn't keep that close a track, but swing and a miss. Strike two. And strike three, got him. So that'll bring up the left fielder, LJ Evans. He's 0 for 2 today. Flew out to center and grounded out to the second baseman. And he hits that ball over to first. And Hunter scoops it and flips it over to Adams for the second out of the inning. That'll bring up Derek Hald, the catcher, who is yet to record an official at-bat in this game. He's walked twice. Almost makes me wonder if he does swing the bat. First pitch there was a ball. That's in there for a strike. Strike two. Outside, ball two. 2-2 is the count. Ow. That ball gets lined right back up the middle. And bounces off Dawson Adams' shins. Hence why I said ow. It brings up the shortstop, Alex Hess. Guess that answers my question if he swings the bat, though. Gave Dawson a little verify your okay throw. So Alex steps in. He's 1-for-2 today. Flown out to the shortstop and singled to left. He hits that ball into the air into center field. Nate Yeary with another diving catch. That's two. Great catches by Nate Yeary out there in center. He's doing a great job for the Builders today. And we'll be back with the bottom of the sixth inning right after this.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII, building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy. The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans. Thanks to them, we all have our freedom and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina and I work for HII.
All right, welcome back. Welcome back into War Memorial Stadium. Builders have the bottom of the lineup due up. 7-8-9, Riggs Ellis, Matt Phoebus, and Jet Winslow. Whereas, you know, me talking about finishing, in essence, finishing your previous at-bat, that ball got through as Ellis singled to center. In essence, Ellis would have been in that same boat, would have came back up to bat with the same count he had before. Because Hunter Johnson was picked off at first. Now Matt Phoebus is up with one out. I'm sorry, no outs. And there goes Riggs. As he got tagged on the face. One and two's a, or one and one's a count. Two and one. And Riggs foul, not Riggs, that's Phoebus, fouls that one away. It bounces in the parking lot. Bouncy, bouncy, bouncy. And rolls under the truck. Phoebus hits it to the third baseman over to first. Oh, that's not good. Maybe it's not as bad as I thought. You know, anytime you see a guy running, though, and then grabs the back of his leg, you kind of instinctively think the worst, to be honest. But he is walking off under his own power. That's a great sign for Matt Phoebus. All right, so that'll bring up Jet Winslow, the right fielder. The first pitch he sees is a ball. And he skies that one to center field. And that'll do it for the Builders' half of the sixth inning. Top of the seventh coming up when we come back here on the Builders Sports YouTube channel.
Bayport gives away $100,000 in tuition assistance. Our scholarships are special because we not only allow funds to be applied to colleges and universities, but also trade and vocational schools. The submission deadline for all scholarships this year is a close of business on March 31st. Please share this opportunity with family, friends, students, and colleagues. Like, share, or comment on social media.
I am Fatima Medina, and I work for HII, building the most powerful ships in the U.S. Navy. The digital technology I use is a generational change in the way that we build ships, making the construction of aircraft carriers more efficient. Plus, I get to work with veterans. Thanks to them, we all have our freedom and we need to work hard to keep it. I am Fatima Medina and I work for HII.
All right, into left field for the Builders is number 28, Brady Bonilla. He's taken over for Matt Phoebus. So due up is the top of the order for the Bearcats. Dylan Schmoody, Mario Disso, and Vincent Amatucci. So Schmoody's one for three today. First pitch he looks at is a strike. Second pitch is a ball. Hits that up the middle to the shortstop. Scooped up on the throw by Hunter Johnson for the first out of the inning. So that'll bring up Mario Disso. He's 0 for 2 in this game. Flown out to center and right field and reached on an error. You remember to the top of the fifth. That error is actually what kind of caused all the damage. And he gets hit by the pitch. So that'll bring up Vincent Amatucci, the third baseman, who's 1 for 3 today with 2 strikeouts. What? Oh, and there's also a pinch runner, Jonathan Taylor, Tyler. Taylor. Jeremy Harmon went out to give Dawson a word of encouragement. Little low, the first pitch to Vincent. Was a ball. That is ripped into right left field. Runners will move up 90 feet. Bring up the right fielder, Billy Perose. Also might be the end of Dawson's day, as it is. Dawson went 2 1/3 innings with 2 strikeouts, threw 31 pitches. He's responsible for the runners on first and second. So that'll bring in Jaden Anderson to pitch. Jaden came in and got the last out of the last game for the Builders. They, however, could not come back and put up any runs or put up enough runs in their half of the inning in order to secure the win. So Jaden's going to try to put an end to the bleeding or stop it before it starts, I guess, is maybe a better way to say it. He's coming in with one out and two runners on, first and second. As he faces the cleanup hitter, Billy Perros, who's 1 for 3 today. With a strikeout that flew out to left and singled to left field. Jaden's a sophomore at the Prentice School. This comes out of Charleston, West Virginia. Coming into Wild Thing. Another, in essence, going back to the baseball movie references from yesterday. Major League. Pretty good movie franchise. All right, so Jaden's ready. Perros is ready. And that's in there for a strike. Bounced to third. Fires across the diamond for one. So in some ways a productive out if you're a Bearcat fan. Brings up number 40, Austin Terpak. So for one with an RBI in this game. I'm trying to, he's 0 for 1. He's grounded. He's flown out to center. Sack or to right, had a sacrifice fly to right and has walked. It's in there for a strike, 1-1. Whew. Ooh, that's one of those that I feel like's been called a strike all day. So 2-1. Swing and a miss, strike two. .86 miles an hour. Registered on the radar gun, which seems to read less than it picks than it doesn't, but that's okay. That ball was grounded to short, and thrown over to first. So that'll do it. The Builders win game two of today's doubleheader, 6-5. 6-5. St. Vincent College put up 5 runs on 3 hits and had 1 error. The Builders put up 6 runs on 8 hits and committed 2 errors in this game. The next time the Builders hit the field will be Friday here at War Memorial Stadium, and that'll be against Mid-Atlantic Christian University, affectionately known as MACU. They'll take on the Mustangs. They'll turn around Saturday and take on the Mustangs, but they'll be going down to Elizabeth City for that one. So we appreciate you guys tuning in, and be back with us on Friday. This is David Davenport signing off, and thank you for your time.